And
On
so we do have a lot
Creator
of fortunes, even though we all have our struggles as well. We do have you and we have each other. And we're able to meet, like we're meeting now. And we're also trying to move perhaps from a phase of more of an open smorgasbord into a more structured menu, as we're, some of us are entering into the various programs that are being offered. And then of course with the upcoming retreat. And so it's a small community, and we're also coming from very different backgrounds in terms of practice. Some are very experienced, some might be newer ones, some might have a lot of practice commitments and other ones may not have. And so I think one of the challenges is of course to for each and every one of us to find an authentic practice that is balanced, that is allowing us to step onto this path while honoring whatever previous teachings and commitments and teachers we have, because there is no low or high dharma in that sense. It's all dharma, whatever we may have been fortunate to have received before and what we're receiving now. So that's certainly one thing for each of one of us to hold open as a question and to explore individually, but also together in a dialogue here and perhaps when we're meeting as well. And it's not something that will, I think, too easily answer, neither for us nor for our teacher. So as I said previously, I think meeting, when we're getting together, some of us in the retreat, would allow us to approach these questions in a new way. And also as we're receiving new practices. But of course, practice is what it's all about. And that's where the challenges arise, both in terms of actually being, finding the time, finding, keeping the focus and having the energy to practice. And with that, we can be very sure that we're never alone in that struggle, in living in a modern life where we're having a lot of privileges in terms of most of us having stable enough living conditions financially and having roof above our heads and foods and so on, which is certainly not a given. But we do have some fortunes, but there is a lot more to come in terms of the challenges there. But one of the things I really appreciate and I think is quite unique in terms of the Tibetan Buddhist sort of resettling in the West is Chogyam's emphasis on authenticity, that this is not about sort of erasing yourself and becoming like a Buddha. Like a Buddha is something impersonal or depersonalized or something like that, but it's more of a discovery process and honoring who you are as an individual and the pain you may be suffering and so on. And I think that's quite unique, and that's something for us to treasure and hold together in the space. That I think is quite remarkable that Chogyam is able to create online. I have not really been able to experience that in any other setting. I'm sure there are other groups and teachers that are able to achieve that, but I think that's a precious thing in itself. So I think that's quite wonderful. So I'd like to invite you to do that. I'd like to invite you to always come to us with questions, challenges. We make mistakes. We want to make this work better for everyone. We want to make it practical. We want to make it relevant. And we certainly want to meet everyone wherever they are. Some of you may not be able to come for financial reasons to the retreat, and that's one of the challenges that you may have. But we are emphasizing inclusion and diversity, and we want to support each and every one of you in every way we can with the challenges that you have.